Chancellor Angela Merkel discussed with the heads of state and government of the EU how they can intensify their efforts in the fight against the corona pandemic in view of the sharp rise in the number of infections across Europe. Chancellor Angela Merkel took part in a video conference of the members of the European Council, in which the heads of state and government of the European Union, with the President of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, and the President of the European Council, Charles Michel, discussed the national and European efforts to combat the COVID-19 pandemic. The Chancellor had this regular exchange via video conference at the last meeting of the European Council on 15th-16th October in Brussels. It is planned to continue these informal video conferences regularly. The Chancellor explained which measures were decided in Germany to curb the spread of the coronavirus and bring the number of infections back to a lower level. She has once again made it clear that a coordinated European approach is of great importance in combating the pandemic. For Germany as a country in the middle of Europe, in particular, it is more important that the borders remain open, that there is a functioning economic cycle, and that we fight the pandemic together. The EU heads of state and government have agreed to work more closely together in combating the corona pandemic. Chancellor Merkel emphasized the great importance of a coordinated approach. For Germany, as I said, it's important that the borders are open. And across Europe, the number of infections is currently increasing sharply, and the EU countries are facing enormous challenges. At their summit in mid-October, the heads of state and government had therefore agreed, at the suggestion of Chancellor Angela Merkel, to regularly exchange information on the development and control of the pandemic. For this reason, EU Council President Michel invited the first such meeting for the Thursday right afterwards. First, the EU heads of state and government exchanged their experiences with national measures against the pandemic. They then discussed how member states could work better together at EU level. Chancellor Merkel explained which measures were decided in that week in Germany to curb the spread of the coronavirus and bring the number of infections back to a lower level. She once again made it clear that a coordination is essential. Especially for Germany, as I said, it is essential that the borders are open and the economic cycles function. And the leaders agreed that testing and contact follow-up were critical to containing the spread of the virus and controlling the situation. EU Council President Michel called for rapid mutual recognition of the rapid tests that are now on the market. They could reduce the negative impact on freedom of movement and on our internal market. On October 28th, the EU Commission presented recommendations on COVID-19 test strategies and the use of rapid antigen tests. The EU states now want to continue working on this basis. In order to improve contact tracing across Europe, the countries want to harmonize the different corona warning apps for cell phones. They also discussed harmonizing the quarantine regulations. The EU states also want to work more closely together on the supply of vaccines. The EU Commission has already signed framework agreements for several million vaccine doses with various vaccine manufacturers. Distributing vaccinations as soon as they are available is a huge task, said European Council President Michel. Storage and transport also made high demands here. With a view to distribution, the member states had discussed giving priority to vaccinating certain groups of people, such as the elderly, the chronically ill, and medical staff. And even since the 28th of October, a lot has happened still. In Germany, we already are in a so-called wave breaker lockdown, where all pubs, theaters and stuff are closed. I said that in another video, but you always have to change weekly almost to cope with the situation. And so we will have to deal with this quite some time now. But if you still want to know more about European or global politics, YouTube has chosen another of my videos right here for you on the end screen, right next to your chance to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Click and enjoy. Viel Spaß.